Hello, mysterious person behind the screen. So, we finally got our first Doctor Who of 2016, and our only Doctor Who of 2016, and it was okay. Bearing in mind, I fully expected to hate this episode with fiery, burning passion, but you know what? It was fine. I give it a 5 out of 10 at the most. Nothing more, nothing less. It wasn't as abominable as I thought it was going to be, judging from the children in the clip and the trailers, but it wasn't exactly a masterpiece either. I liked everything with the Doctor and Nardole, and I think Peter Capaldi is just the Doctor now. Every time I see him, I think, yes, that is the Doctor, even though he is still being written inconsistently. It's, again, we've seen another different Doctor from what we started out from and from what we saw last time, but, you know, Capaldi's really trying his best here, and you can really see he is the Doctor, so props to him. And I think he actually works well with Matt Lucas's Nardole, who seems to be playing it more straight this time. Don't get me wrong, he's still the comic relief, and he still has some childish jokes, the restroom, but, you know, I didn't mind him in this, surprisingly. Honestly, what bugged the episode down was the romance between Lucy and Grant, and I love how Doctor Who magazine did the parody of Lois and Clark, the New Adventures of Superman, with on their cover, it was Lucy and Grant, Return of Doctor Mysterio. I really like that was really cool. But yeah, that stuff really bugged it down, I think, and honestly, that was the stuff where I was just bored and not interested. And to be honest, for our only Doctor Who this year, I would have liked it to just focus on the Doctor, but what are you going to do at the end of the day? It was supposed to be cheesy in a way, the whole superhero stuff, but it kind of came off as a bit like they were trying too hard at some points. Like they said they were trying to emulate Superman the movie, and Superman the movie can be campy at some points, but that's sort of just it sort of respects the character enough to do that in Superman the movie. This sort of came off as they were trying too hard to be deliberately cheesy and campy. Sometimes that worked, like when the ghost was like, when he's rescued the people from the fire, and he turns to the camera and goes, "Always use smoke detectors." That made me laugh quite hard. But like the rest of it, when they had that really awful shot of him coming in through the window, flipping, like, spinning around like Linda Carter's Wonder Woman and then changing back into his normal clothes, I was laughing at it, but not in a good way. And I know, again, it's supposed to be cheesy, but like I said, it came off as trying way too hard, and I didn't like it. I wasn't really a fan of it. I find Charity Wakefield's Lucy to be quite annoying indeed. I really don't know. What was it? Mr. Something? Every time she squeezed that thing, I wanted to break into my TV and just kill it, because that was so annoying. It's just, every time she squeezed it, didn't like that at all. Really. Really didn't. But honestly, I'm kind of surprised Justin Chatwin was okay. I mean, if you've seen him in Dragon Ball Evolution, teach me how to be normal. As pointed out by Chris Stuckman in that film, he ceases to act often after he gets his line out, and thankfully he didn't do that in this. He was okay for what it was, and I don't want to like criticize him at all, because like he seems like a really like nice guy in real life from an interview. So I always feel sorry for him when he gets the criticism. But the villains were pretty cool and honestly kind of creepy when they was like, the pulling their faces off and stuff. That was really cool. Although many people were saying, I can't remember what it was, whether it was the Doctor and Nardole or Lucy and Grant or whatever. People were saying there was a classic element, like an element that felt like the classic series in this. And I didn't see that at all. Like, nothing to me really felt classic. I didn't really feel that. And by the end, when Grant saved when Grant was catching the plane and then him and Lucy sort of flew off, it was supposed to be a sort of punch the air moment, like, oh yeah, they're together. But I quite honestly didn't care. I loved the first 20 minutes. Well, I wouldn't say love, I really liked, the first 20 minutes would get a 7 or 8 out of 10, but I feel like the rest of it just sort of, just wasn't great. So, I know people loved it, I know people hated it. For me, I'm straight down the middle with a 5 out of 10. Series 10, however, looks pretty damn good. Like, I don't want to get my hopes up again because Series 9 looked pretty damn good from the trailers, and you know how I feel about that. But Series 10, to be honest, yeah, I'm down with it. I mean, like, I really like the look of Bill. She seems much more like an RTD companion, which, of course, I'm down with. I really like the monsters that we see. The Mervellans are back. I'm not quite sure how I feel about that, since the Mervellans are pretty ridiculous, but fair enough. And, yeah, I just really like the look of it, and Capaldi looks to be great. Like, I really liked him with the kid at the start of Return of Dr. Mysterio, and the kid was actually quite good. I really liked the line, the sort of interplay they had between each other. There was the bit about Spider-Man where Capaldi was like, why do they call him Spider-Man? Someone must hate him. He was like, well, he got bitten by a radioactive spider, and do you know what happened to him? Radiation poisoning, and he died. I really liked that line. That really just made me laugh, and the kid was like, guess what powers he has? And it was like, nausea, sickness, and death within a couple of days. Yeah, really liked it. Series 10, yeah, bring it on. I'm open to it at this point. I just hope it's good for Moffat's last. I'm just going in it with an open mind. I'm just really open to it. I really hope it just delivers some good Doctor Who. So, thanks for watching. Did you like Return of Doctor Mysterio more than I did? Probably. But yeah, if you did, please like, subscribe, comment, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care, mate.